All right, well, nail this topic down with one last example. You can see there's a bunch of parts here. So gives you a graph, and this is a piecewise function again. And it asks questions about the definite integrals, six definite integrals. So there's going to be a lot of calculations to do. I did those. This little first yellow one is 1/2 base times height. It's 1/2. It will be negative if we go the normal direction. And so I calculated areas of each of these separate pieces. That may help with our calculations. So we're going to start with A. It's a good place to start. And it says the integral from 0 to 1 of negative f of x. Now, for integrals, like limits and like derivatives, you can factor out negatives. So that negative 1 can be factored out. And you can just think of this as the integral from 0 to 1 of f of x. You can see from 0 to 1, that's the area is 1/2, but it's below the x-axis. So this integral would be negative 1/2. But we have this negative factored out. So it's negative of a negative 1/2, which is 1/2. That's the answer. One different way to do this problem is you could also do it like this. When you have a negative out in front of an integral, that just means you can just flip the limits. So this integral would be the same as this integral. And this integral says, all right, now go from 1 to 0 of f of x, which means we're going like this. We're going 1 to 0, which means we're going right to left, which means the result is negative 1/2 because it's below the x-axis, but we're going backwards, so it's the opposite. That would be positive 1/2. So either way, you'll get that answer. Second one, B. The integral of 3f of x from 3 to 4. Again, I'm going to factor out that constant. From 3 to 4, you can see right here, the area is 2. So, and it's positive. The graph is positive. So this is just 3 times 2, which is 6. Easy. Part C. The integral from 0 to 7 of f of x. This is straightforward, except, see my area here? I have to stop at 7. So I'm only using part of that. This little area now is 1/2 base, which is 1, times height, which is 1. So this little area is just 1/2. So I'm going to add up all the areas, going in order. From 0 to 1, I have negative 1/2 because it's below. From 1, I'm going to go all the way to 6. It's all positive, so I can just go 2 plus 2 plus 2. That adds 6 to the integral. And as we just said, from 6 to 7, that area is 1/2, but it's negative because it's below the x-axis. So in essence, we just have 6 minus 1, which is 5. That was C. D. We have the integral from 5, the integral from 5 to 11 of f of x. We're kind of on the same situation as last problem. We're starting in the middle of this area, and that's 1/2 base times height. Again, that's still 1/2. We're going left to right, so you just add up all the areas. If above the x-axis, they're positive. If below, it's negative. So this would be 1/2. And then from 6 to 10 is my next big area. That's 2 plus 2, which is 4, but it's below. And then the last little area from 10 to 11 is positive, 1/2. So 5 to 11 is this. It's a negative 4 plus 1, which is negative 3. E. The integral from 0 to 11, that's the whole way. So you're just going to add up all the areas. You can do it like I'm going to, you can do that if that's how you prefer it. I'm going to start. You can say that this one, negative 1/2, is going to cancel out with this positive 1/2. This negative 2 and this negative 2 is going to cancel out with this positive 2, this positive 2, and you're left with only this area, which is 2. That's one way you can do that. The other way, of course, is just to go back and add up and subtract as appropriate each individual area. Last one is the integral from 4 to 10. F of x dx, and this one isn't too exciting. This is just from here to here. So we have a positive 2 minus 2 minus 2. So a positive 2 minus 2, that's gone. And then minus 2, that's to be a negative 2. One more, I'm going to add. What comes after F, G? I'm going to add one more because we didn't do one that goes from right to left yet. So let's just say the integral of negative 10 F of X from, say, let's go from 10 to 6. So one way you can do this is factor out the negative 10. And then the integral from of f of x from 10 to 6, we're going this way. Normally that integral would be negative 4 because it's below. That's if we're going left to right, but since we're going right to left, it's the opposite. So that would actually come up as a positive. And negative 10 times positive 4 is negative 40. That's it. So, and one last thing about that problem, as I said before, you could also do it this way. I'm just going to go back to here. Once I factor out that negative 10, you can make any integral the opposite sign. I can make this positive 10 if I flip signs. Now we're going from left to right, so it's a normal integral. So this is 10 times. The integral from 6 to 10 would be negative 4 since it's below the x-axis. So you get negative 40. That is it. Practice these. They're pretty easy.